In this week's space startup news, we cover two US startups teaming up to develop a nuclear-powered spacecraft. In our second story, we cover Varda Space's third mission blasting off on a SpaceX Transporter mission. And lastly, we cover updates from Gravitics, a space station module builder. Quick note, I'm not covering the Blue Ghost Lander today, as I'll have a wrap-up video on that mission later. Also, ISA Aerospace could launch for the very first time on Monday. I'll have a video covering that launch after it happens. Okay, let's get started. Exlabs and Antares team up to build nuclear-powered spacecraft for deep space missions. California startups Exlabs and Antares announced a partnership on the 19th of March to develop a nuclear-powered spacecraft for deep space missions. Exlab has developed a science exploration and resource vehicle, and Antares develops scalable microreactors, so the companies decided to combine these two technologies to create a nuclear-powered spacecraft that can travel into deep space. Matthew Schmidgal, Exlab's CEO and co-founder, explained the rationale. Nuclear is key to enabling extended, long-duration missions. It provides high power and consistent energy for larger propulsion systems and larger payloads. Solar panels cannot provide the type of power that's required for our envisioned future operations, unquote. The company's plan to launch a spacecraft equipped with the Antares nuclear microreactor to geostationary orbit in late 2028 or 2029 as a demonstration. This mission will serve as a critical validation for space-based nuclear power and set the stage for broader adoption of nuclear technologies for missions beyond geostationary orbit, according to the news release. Will Madsen, Antares' head of mission engineering, added, "The Exolab Antares partnership pairs two companies with an ambitious vision and pragmatic roadmaps to bring space nuclear technologies to bear. For too long, space nuclear power has solely existed in conceptual studies. Now it's time to build," unquote. Nuclear power, both on Earth and in space, has long grappled with technical and safety challenges. However, recent efforts by companies of all sizes are focused on shrinking reactors while boosting their safety. Schmidgal noted, "We see a growing interest in the national security space in extended mission vehicles, which require nuclear capabilities. National security and cislunar infrastructure are going to require these capabilities," unquote. Nuclear power is also a core element of Exlab's long-term roadmap. The startup was founded in 2023 to help pave the way for space resource utilization. "The design of our spacecraft and the technology that we're building needs to support that nuclear future," Schmidgal said. Okay, on to our second story of the week. Varda Space's W-3 mission launches. Varda Space, fresh from the successful landing of the W-2 capsule in the Australian outback, has launched its W-3 capsule on SpaceX's Transporter 13 mission. This, as the W-3 name suggests, is the third orbital mission launched by Varda Space as their launch cadence increases. The W-3 mission rode along with 73 other payloads into a sun-synchronous orbit. For this mission, the W-3 capsule carries a specialized payload developed by the US Air Force. It's an IMU, or Inertial Measurement Unit. This particular device is designed to operate under the extreme conditions of hypersonic re-entry, where speeds can reach or exceed Mach 25. This will be the first time an IMU device has been exposed to such high-velocity conditions. The test could improve navigation and control systems for future hypersonic vehicles by providing critical data from the re-entry environment. After deployment, the W-3 capsule is operating normally, with a signal from the spacecraft having been acquired and all health checks passed. The capsule will remain in orbit for several weeks before re-entering the atmosphere and landing at the Kiniba Test Range in South Australia, the same as the previous W-2 mission. If you would like to know more about the W-2 mission and how the re-entry process works, check out my video on that mission. The link is in the description. Okay, on to our last story this week. Gravitics progress update. Gravitics, a US-based company specializing in space station modules, recently shared an update on their efforts to launch their first space station module. In a post on the X platform, they say, "PDR success. Gravitics completed the design review for our first commercial module. This is an important milestone that validates our spacecraft design. Concurrent with the PDR, Gravitics showcased substantial build progress, including a flight-like dome prototype and tooling for module construction," unquote. The company plans to produce space station modules that commercial space station companies can buy to add to their stations. Their modules come in a variety of sizes to fit into different sized fairings. Their lineup begins with a 4-meter diameter module, compatible with most medium lift rockets. Following the successful debut of Blue Origin's New Glenn rocket, which features a 7-meter fairing, Gravitics can now launch their 6-meter medium-sized module. Their largest offering, an 8-meter module, is designed for SpaceX's Starship, taking full advantage of its massive payload capacity. In 2024, Gravitics hit several key milestones. They secured over $100 million in contracts, delivered hardware to the International Space Station, signed a Space Act agreement with NASA, and completed a project for the Space Force, and finalized an internal preliminary design review, or PDR, for their first commercial module. A major highlight was a $125 million contract from Axiom Space to supply a pressurized module for Axiom's future commercial space station. This 4-meter diameter module, equipped with its own propulsion and power systems, will serve primarily as a utility unit, offering storage space with minimal additional furnishings. Okay, that's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Quick note, in the coming weeks, I'll be launching a live stream to recap the videos I posted, answer your questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Stay tuned for details. Be sure to like and subscribe so you'll see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.